Now, the first thing we will do is creating a new layer where we will store the bitmaps that we will insert for modeling the project on top of them. So we'll call this bitmaps, and we'll create 4 sublayers for each one of the bitmap that we will create now. We'll call this ground floor, first floor, terrace floor, and elevation. Now, for inserting the bitmaps, we're going to run picture frame command that we find under the surface icon frame. We select the ground floor first and we will just insert it in the model. We are inserting it with a random scale, so we will change it according to the proper scale since we have here a reference scale bar. But in order to scale all the bitmaps at the same time, we will insert them together and scale them together. But first, we will select this object and place it already on that new layer we have created before. So we do right-click on it and change object layer. Now we repeat the same steps as before for inserting first floor. It is important that you snap on the corner of the previous frame in order to insert it in the same scale as the other one. We can hide now this ground floor in order to just see the other file, and we will place it in the first floor layer. We will repeat the same operation with the terrace floor. We hide now the first floor, we select this one and put it in the terrace floor. Change object layer. We will do the same for the elevation bitmap. So we select this south elevation file. We will insert it snapping on the other bitmaps, assuming that they have the same scale. And now selecting this and putting it to the elevation layer. Change object layer. Now, let's scale these 4 bitmaps according to the right scale. So we're going to work from the top viewport, and since we have this scale bar, we're going to use it to scale the bitmap. So we'll draw an auxiliary line that goes from 0 to 3 meters according to the image. We'll run this cell all command to select these 4 surfaces and the curve, and we will run the scale 2D command. So we select this point as the first reference point, this end line point as the second one, and we're going to type 3 meters in the command line to scale this in the right dimension. So this is not really giving an accurate scaling and probably not giving us a round number. So if we dimension, for example, if we draw a rectangle for the boundary of the model, and now we measure this side of the rectangle, we can see we go to analyze distance and we measure this point to that point, that is not giving us a round number. So if we want to give, for example, this side of the model 19 meters, we're going to select everything again. We repeat the same scale to the command, and from this point to that point, now we'll make the model measure 19 meters exactly. What we're going to do now is to take the elevation bitmap, so we're going to select it first. We're going to use the gumball to rotate it, so let's put here 90 degrees, and we will place it in the right position and elevation. So from the front viewport, we're going to take this elevation as the zero elevation. We're going to move it until this reaches the zero elevation. And now we just need to for example, enable the ground floor and make sure this is located exactly in the same position as the boundary of the bitmap of the ground floor. We're going to place it in the back side of the drawing. There we go. Now we need to place each bitmap in the right elevation, but we will do this in the next chapter after creating the levels in that model.